The web was still young, and so was the law. It was the sweltering summer of 2004 when a group of legal scholars convened to discuss the law of the Internet at a meeting supported by the Berkman Center for Internet and Society. The event was called iLaw. It was a time of economic strife.
We have to pay somewhere up to $2.50 a gallon for gasoline that regulates our ability to drive cars.
A time of frustration.
Why is video streaming so unreliable?
A time of roaming gangs of youths who threatened the sanctity of the Internet. The first iLaw session was held in the rustic venue of the Harvard Law School. The conference was 2 days long and had four key themes: privacy, property, speech, and governance. The program sought to bring together the talents of a ragtag crew of outlaws, degenerates, and Harvard Law School professors, the likes of which the great frontier of cyberspace had never before seen. Among others, the group included yokai, wise guy, Benkler.
But for purposes of having an open information environment, we have to reserve some cluster that are not systematically by law and policy tilted towards market exchanges as opposed to conversations.
The contemplative William Fisher.
All of these efforts to protect against corrosion the traditional business models, the fortunes of the record industry, and soon the fortunes of the film industry, are declining.
Lawrence Lucky Lessig.
So that they don't use their power in regulating the space in a way which would, in fact, simply weaken or destroy the great opportunities that the Internet might produce.
Charles the Kid Nesson. And Jonathan Trigger Happy Zittrain.
Oops, time for football practice.
Little remains of those halcyon summer days and plenary sessions, but the few remaining clips from that period give a unique glimpse into where internet law came from and where it would soon be going.
Someday, but someday just isn't here yet.